Hey ladies, it's Candace from Candace C Fitness, and I am here to talk today about some simple ways you can decrease stress in your daily life. And it's not big crazy things, big to-do lists or anything like that. It's just little ways you can do to help decrease the stress that we all are going through right now. Right now is a crazy time in our life. And to say that none of us are stressed is a lie. In some way, shape, or form, we've been impacted by COVID-19, and we need to really work on keeping our stress levels down so it doesn't affect us down the road via our hormones or just our cycles, or if we already have underlying conditions like hormonal imbalance or things like that. Stress is going to be that much worse for us. So, what can we do to really help improve our stress levels? And there's some little things that you can add into your daily life that I'm going to go over today. So, number one is you can start by journaling. Yes, journaling. And I'm not saying that you have to spend 10 minutes a day journaling. I'm saying just think about what you're feeling. Wake up. Use your phone or use a good pen and paper. Like, I'm a big time, I gotta write everything down. And really lean into what you're feeling. Each day, try to track, are you feeling stressed right now? Are you feeling better today, more energy? Were you able to get that workout in without a problem? Was so-and-so getting on your nerves more today? Did you have more relationship issues? Did you feel hungrier? All that kind of stuff can really lean into helping you get more in tune with your body, which is gonna help you get your stress levels down. Now, hold on to this, hear me out. The reason being is because throughout the month, we rise and fall with our hormones, and we should be more stressed. Honestly, we should feel more stressed at certain times than we do at others. That may be crazy to you to think, but it's the facts. And that's because we have more tension. Our hormones, when they start to fall, our body is naturally in a more stressed out state. So the second half of our cycle is when we should be more stressed. And then other things come into play too, like when you have more energy at the beginning of your cycle, then that should be how it flows. But if you start to notice these things at different times of the month, you can kind of lean into those things and you should feel better because of it. And as a reality, you'll forgive yourself a little bit more. So you can think, oh, it's this time of the month, so it's okay that I don't have the energy I had yesterday or last week for that workout. It's normal. I'm not crazy. It's normal. And you can prove that to your husband too, or whoever thinks you're crazy, because I know that that's a daily conversation in my household. Anyways, so that's one thing. Start leaning into that, on feeding off of that. Number two is recognizing how you feel after you work out. So if you are someone who, or even just going for a walk, some days if you kind of lean into and really think about, so am I feeling good today? I went for a walk. I walk every day. A lot of us are trying to get outside more, get moving more. How did I feel? Do I feel better this week than I did last week? Think about those things and think about how the differences and tracking them. So you can also journal this or just keep it in an app if you track your workouts or things like that. Really leaning into, and I'm using that word a lot, but it's so good, but leaning into how you feel and who you are as a person and not beating yourself up for it. Because certain times of the month, you should have more energy for a workout versus others. Number three is deep breathing. Now, this is something that I've talked about a lot, but we need to deep breathe. It's how we're supposed to breathe. We're supposed to use our diaphragm, which sits kind of right down, like below our rib cage, if you will, kind of behind it, but below, below our lungs. And we want, when we inhale, we should be using that. That muscle should really be helping, like, build those lungs, pull those lungs to wear it down and kind of pull your ribs down so your lungs can expand and really fill with air. So then when you exhale, you can contract your core and get all that air out. And what that does is it takes tension out of our neck and shoulders that we all tend to have. And it's because a lot of times, not only do we hold our shoulders like this as women, and a lot of men do too, but we also shallow breathe. So we just breathe all through here. So we're just constantly using those muscles, when in reality, we should be inhaling and everything should be expanding in the front and the back. In the back, that's the key. And then exhaling it all out. So if you can take like a few minutes, a few times a day, to just really focus on your breathing, and you can do this in the car when you are sitting down at night, just at your desk, whatever it may be, just really focusing on inhaling, letting that, not that, your chest will move, so don't get that twisted. Have your chest expand, your belly expand, your back expand, and then exhale it all out. So think inhale for two, exhale for like three or four, and repeat it a few times for about a minute or so. And then do it again later. And the more you do it, the more you're going to feel relaxed. It helps release those relaxation hormones that we need to feel that calm, to get that tension and that stress, that cortisol down. It really can play into that. So that's the next thing you want to do. Another thing is just getting outside. And that's so easy to do right now. I mean, unless it's pouring down rain, but vitamin D can play a huge role in our stress, in our lives, and how we feel, whether we have energy, if we're lethargic. It just really can get our stress down. So get outside for a few minutes. Just get some fresh air, get some vitamin D. And as much as I would say take a vitamin D supplement, there's just nothing better than sunshine. And I get it that some you may be really cold, or it may be really hot, or it may not be the easiest thing for you to do, but just do your best, or even buy one of those lights that produce the same thing. I don't know much about it, but I know they can work. But you just want some good sunlight, not a tanning bed, sunlight, okay? So those are some easy things you can do. Start implementing right now. Just try to do one thing a day. Take some time for you. That's another thing, actually. Let me hold on. Hold that thought. Actually, just finding something that's going to bring you joy, spark that joy, if you will, every day for just a minute or two. And it doesn't have to be the same thing as like your best friend or your husband or anything like that. If you love reading, read for a couple minutes. If you love going outside, go outside. Go for that walk, go for that run, do something that's gonna make you feel better, okay? Taking some time for you is going to help down the road, and it's gonna play into your relationships as well, okay? So we've got leaning into who we are, essentially, with understanding how we feel every day, post our workouts, post-workout, if you will, not like post them online, but figuring out how you feel after those and really leaning into that deep breathing, getting outside and doing something for yourself. Really try to lean into all that. There I go, I said it again. But it really can help, and I hope that you can take something from this and really just be your best self. Lean into who you are. There I go again. Be you and be thankful for who you are, okay? Just don't beat yourself up. Everyone is going through something right now. And if they're not, everyone will at some point. It's life. Don't beat yourself up over it. Know that you're strong enough to overcome whatever it is, and you will. So decrease that stress, feel better, and I will catch you next time. All right, guys, I'm Candace from Candace C Fitness. Be sure to subscribe, like this video, and I hope to connect with you soon. You can also get on my email list so you can stay in the know and learn more about my cycle syncing one-on-one program. Catch you next time, y'all.